by Whiteman on the back straight. And look at this, Willie Hill involved in a sensational crash on the home straight here, 5-5-0.
For many years, had a bad year last year, but that's what he's got to beat. Truck, he's going for it, first time, and he's gone, and he's gone. No solo riders here. Why not five left the wheel? And we go, oh my god, on the back straight, what a incredible way that looks. All the officials are there to make sure that...
Coming to join in, need some help, brother? Here I come. Oh, I say, and he completely mullered Chris Carter.
Had a bad year last year, but that's what he's got a beaten truck. He's going for it, first time, and he's gone, and he's gone, and he's gone, and he's done it! Jockey's done a triple!
After being a novice at this 10 months ago, he is now certainly one of the experts. Let's see what the youngster from Rockford can do. He's throwing it in, and he's gone. A one, a two, a three, he's done, no! 3 3/4 for Wayne Holton!
20th as part of our world final meeting. 2:38. Oh, I tell you what, that's wiggly waggling well. And he's done it! Goodness gracious me! Now that is superb! And that's what we don't want to see, by the way, at the end of it. It's pretty slow down the back straight, but plenty of wobble. And he's going for it. And he's done it! Yes, it's over! A beauty! Or is it still the one from the lawnmower? No, he's going a bit quicker this time. 3.77, plenty of bounce and wobble, and yes! Oh! Oh! Oh, I say! That one was trying to go a lot more. And now the officials are rolling over! It's all happening today at Arena Essex. The barking stunt driver, 5.54, Chalky Douglas, going in with plenty of power, throwing it in now, and it's a one, it's a two! which idiot put the arm code there?
Down the straight, you can't help it. But it's all tight and usually very well. There's more injuries in football, really.
The yellow-orange ones are in the fence. No solo riders here. Why not five left to win? And we go, oh my God, on the back straight, what a incredible way that looks. All the officials are there to make sure that that's right. Big snake on with the gladiators. And Gary McCarthy's going for the chain-snapping routine, but the vampires are... Whoa, look at that! What's that? Eight abreast, oh, and the vampires have split. They're out, they're only at half a lap to go. And first and second both go in a tremendous crash on the back straight. One lap to go for 313, Bob. 417 is in second on the previous lap. But the 313 team of Brian Orris have now got half a lap to go, and they won. Look at the, it's just disintegrated. The 477 car of Andy Wallace has just fallen.
I can't understand why they can't get into the first. Oh, and look at this, Wallace. And, oh, brilliant. Wallace, Wallace. And Les Smith and John McIntyre, home of fire. Oh, the glitch of the Wallace. What a fantastic goal.
Foot on the floor and they're having a real laugh down there, and in comes another hit from Dangerous Dave. Cliff Mills gets turned round, oh, in a big way, and God blimey, Pat Wardle gives him another whack, The radio won't work anymore. Dave Edwards still going at Stewart coming on the back straight. 1957. Andy Gates 205 puts Dave in a sandwich. A Canterbury sandwich indeed. And it's all good fun. Meanwhile, 577 is the leader, Henry. Here he comes now. Halfway, 577. 472. Then it's 5.55 and 2.75 and 84 and 5 laps to go as 19 picks up 57 again and tries to bury him, and 2.05's in there as well, and it's Dave Edwards versus the Canterbury boys here. Pat Ward's turned it round in 6.34 and Dave Edwards is lifting the back wheels in the air of the 57 Sherpa. 19 really enjoying himself. Everybody else staying right out of the way. And he finally spins him out with a bit of help from Spindle.
93, Rob Chittle in second place. About to give him a bit of a tap, perhaps. Here they come now, they're both sideways. 497 and 93. 126 in third place, Retard Roy. Giving Andy Gates the turn left treatment there. Oh, and we have got a roller! And it's Dennis Whiteman who's rolled it on the back straight!
584. George Watmore's going to get a hell of a bump start in a minute on the back straight. Ooh! And a bit of a crash on the exit to turn four. Wacko! Wow, that's a bit more like it! Oh, the lad's getting stuck in now, all right. And here comes the leader. It's 2-3-1, Mike Wayman.
Oh, and Pete Ford has just tested the Armco. 159, Dave Taylor having a pop at Brian Roberts. And it looks like the Suicide Squad custard cream aggression has started already as McCangus and Capon have a massive crash down here. And Russ McCangus, if he comes round, Bob, give him a black flag before he kills himself. So number 21 going for a big finish and almost getting it. Meanwhile, Taylor spins Price on the back straight. Gad picks up Skinny and gives him a push. McCangus goes, oh, and he's taken out 104. So it's 159, the leader, 21, hot wrecking on the pit bend. 21 looking for another big one. Oh, he just missed 510, and he just missed it 159.
And 340, Mel Reid rolls it on turn two, you lucky blighters over there in the sunshine. Meanwhile, in the race, 84, Mick Perkins is the leader. 5.10, oh, blimey! An almighty T-bone from 205, Andy Gates. 84, 452, 156, 275, 381. Those are the leaders. Mick Perkins, the leader, as 472 turns it round and misses everybody. Roy Rawlins has been spun. And Roy decides to retaliate. And some of them are retaliating even before they've been hit. This is the stuff. This is what they want. If they had motor racing on Tiswas, this is what it would have been. And it's 84 and 452, the leading pair. 275 and 156. 543 and somebody else. Big pile up on the exit to turn four. 84, the leader. 84, Mick Perkins is halfway there, Henry. And the second place man has been stuffed into the Armco. on turn four. And again, 368 gives him a pummeling. Well, he is bad company. 275, Ian Madison goes up into second. 543, Colin Logan running in third. 331, Spindles fourth. 104, Canvey Cowboy fifth. John Harding gets two wheels in the air. The Flying Gert is spun by Roy Rawlins. And 84, Nick Perkins is over half a lap clear now, Henry. 84, is this going to be Perky's year? On the back straight, third place Logan gets slaughtered. John Harding is wiping them all out. 275, Ian Madison, second. 104, up into third now, Colin Campbell. 84, Mick Perkins the leader. And there's a big pile up in front of him, and he brilliantly avoids it. 84, Mick Perkins the leader. Can't think why. And with five laps to go, it's 84 in the lead. Oh, 543 does a double hit on 162 and 104. 162 turns around for revenge and gets 104. The third place man is in trouble. We could have a new third here. We could have a new third. It's 381 up to third, Henry. Just gone past. 548 is now fourth. 275 is second. And 84, the leader, spinning out the placemen now. And the leader gets a big whack up the back from 381, Roger Cater, who's third. 555 up to fifth. The leader's been spun, but he's still running. And he's been caught. 84 and 275 together. Three next time, Henry. And 275, Ian Madison from Basildon has caught 84, Mick Perkins. He gives him a whack. Oh, Spindle's in there as well. First and second together on the back straight. 84 and 275. Perkins really fast, too fast. Madison comes through. Perkins hits him. Madison holds it. Perkinson hits him again. 275 takes the lead, Ian Madison. 84, Mick Perkins chasing him round the top bend and down the back straight. It's 275 and 84 with two laps to go now. Here comes Perky. Oh! And Ian Madison survives. 275, the leader. 584, 609. 454, 203, coming through. And 19, Dave Edwards thunders in at the back of 57, Stuart coming. I wonder if Stuart saw that one. I should think so. 58, John Nichols buries himself in 313, Brian Ellis. 57, Stuart coming with the engine hanging out, is still running. 454, Ian Kaplan leads, 203 second. But look at the destruction derby going on down there on turn four. Well, it's spread into turn three now. Oh, 95, Sterling Cape on a mega blitz on some poor soul. And 57 puts it in reverse. Then puts it into first. Then back into reverse. 203, Roughneck Bernie winning the race. Well, I never. 55, Chris Whiteman gets a big one from Tom Watmore. George Watmore. Sorry, George. So, who's winning? It's 203 in the lead. 564 buries himself. Dear me. Pick the bones out of that. Well, it's a good job we've got a camera right in the middle of that destruction derby. And 203 winning. 85, Jeff Griffin up to second place now. 57, Stuart Cumming. Still looking for more. There's the winner, the new champion, 275, Ian Madison, doing his second lap. Well, he's all the way through. 454, Ian Kaplan's got up to second. 159, Skinny is skinnier. And, oh, did you see that? 454, Ian Kaplan deliberately drove past another van. Whereas 108 didn't. Henry thought that was it. Oh, Stuart Adcock going in well there. On 248, Chris Carter still running. Using the back of his van. Well, I don't know who that was. I've got a feeling it was Stuart Cumming tiptoeing to safety there. Across the roofs of the van. Yes, it was. He danced his way across the rooftops there. Now then, let's have a check and see who's still in the running. 58 and 275 are running on the back straight, albeit slowly. 388 still running and 548 still running. How many laps is that for 548? Four laps. Chris Carter showing off today. The new red top. 548. Chris Carter completing his fourth lap. 84, Mick Perkins has decided he doesn't want him to complete any more. 40 odd of them stopped very quickly. So here is the tarmac king, 275 Ian Madison. 548 Chris Carter lines him up. 84 Mick Perkins is the leader in terms of laps, but he's done a few on the speedway track. Chris Carter tries to spin Ian Madison. He does. And 275 stuck on a tyre. 84, big swipe at 548. The whole body of the 548 van has moved across and in. But Chris Carter nonchalantly changes gear. I must get this delivery done today, he says. The exhaust is hanging off. Beautifully prepared Cortinas. The squad favouring 2.3 is the DBs with 1600s and we are underway. It has begun and Chris Whiteman launches himself at Gary Turner and they're both in the fence. Dennis Whiteman makes a brilliant start, number 35. And 96 Cam Wilshire is going to. Blimey, Jamie Darkoff gets mullered by Tony Pilbara. Burrows is completely squashed and now we could have a new leader. We have, it's wide three, Neil Barber, who takes the lead.
Four, the Dangerous Brothers. In car 81 for the chaps, 250 giving him the evil eye no doubt as they cruise around at the rear of the grid is Tony Pimbara. There's the green flag, away they go. And it's first blood to the chaps. Oops, no, it's second blood. Dear, oh dear, that certainly didn't quite go according to plan. They're getting about 6 for 1.5. Sonny Sherwood straight in the back of 79. And look at this car here in front of us. 4-1, this is absolute destruction. 313, 603, I don't know. Well, the driver's still trying to find forward gear. That's triumph of optimism over practicality there, I think. considering the state of his car, but in the big steam from number 13 on 6.03. 2.44 goes in there hard. This is absolute chaos. On the pit turn, we got 98 and 2.09 hard at it. Excellent stuff, Kev Weller, 98, Richie Jones. Getting stuck in, 381 goes into joining. There's hardly a car running at the moment. 10 laps, I don't think we're going to last 10 laps. 71 is starting to put some distance. Ray Woodward has appeared to be a runner for the Mag 7. Here he comes. He's a blue grade driver. He's fairly quick. He hasn't got too many other people waiting to take him out right now, it must be said. So I rather think we could be looking at a magnificent 7 victory here, if anyone can stop there. 373 is the second place driver now. And 373 for the chaps, Roy Laybourne. Roy can see the lead. 388, oh no! Madness, 388, I'm afraid to say. Kev Woods went and put his teammate, who was leading the race, into the pack. 71 gets away, he's enjoying himself with the look of it, Ray Woodward. Switching around all over the place. A lot of 14ers being reduced to scrap before your very eyes. It looks like 348, Sonny Sherwood's car appears to have already been through the crusher before they even take it home. 381 and 250 doing a few head-ons. 388 and 81 Driscoll chasing each other about. 388, Kev Woods is not going to let go of if he can possibly help it, but Driscoll not actually feeling too much problem with that. 291 is second, 71 is in the lead, in fact. Sorry, not third. 71, Ray Woodward is the leader. He's been there for saying, no, brilliant stuff. Well done, lads. They're still determined to take each other out. That was Ray Woodward leading, taken out by number 250, Tony Pimbra, from his team. Tony not exactly performing according to the game plan there. And what's more, Ray Wood out of it. Is anyone going to check to see if Tony Pimbra was in the pay of the chaps? Halfway. For next time, 291 is Val the leader. Thank you very much. There's not too many of them left, is there? Oh dear, he's going to get him back into the race now, having put him out of it. Nice move, right? Good idea. 291 the leader then. It's still the 7 up front, and there's only four of them perhaps. Gary Turner the leader. Only one. Oh, he's on fire. I suggest that you might want to exit that car now, and I rather think that that would be a good idea if everybody told him so. Yep, he's out of there. That's okay. Ray Woodward abandoning ship a bit smartish when he saw the flame. So what do we got then? We've got 2.5 cars still running for the Mag 7. We've got one car still running for the Chaps, and that is 549 Ant Ireland, who is on the back stretch. Looking, or rather hoping, that none of these green ones are going to catch up with him. And taking it very steady, he has got 291 the leader. The leader will have a bit of a problem. He's got two laps to go. This time for 291, Gary Turner. Turner's problem will be, does he wait to finish the race, or does he try and duff up 549 and Ireland when he passes him? A hard question for any banger driver, but probably one will be answered with the usual one of violence. Right, 291 then, the leader, and we've got 549, ooh, now then, we've got 388, the infamous Mr. Woods, now skulking behind a pile of cars at the advice of his teammates, waiting to take out the chap's 549 car. He does succeed in doing so.
Have a terrific start for the Banger Team Championship Final. And Kevin King is almost rolled again over the Armco, this time by Gary Turner. Taylor's in a big pile up on the home straight. Royce goes in there. Tony Mitchell's been turned round. And at the start, it's the Mag 7 who take the initiative. Barber and Cook as Wilshire takes an almighty head on with Kev Waller. And they're like a pair of dogs down there now. So Waller and Wilshire knotted, and it's 79-319. And has Bob Cook lost his steering there? I think he has. He has. Looks like the near side is locked up. 79, Dave Barber gets through the DB at the top end of the circuit. And it's all happening at the top end of the circuit. We've got a camera on the pit bend. And the wrecking is on turn two. And what wrecking it is as well. Here's the leader. And he's been nobbled by Burrows. It's 79, Dave Barber. 319, Bob Cook. And Jamie Dykoff go into the Armco. Dykoff bounces back. And now we have a new leader. It's 97, Jamie Dykoff for the Suicide Squad. And 17, Taylor. I don't believe it. Taylor's racing. 319, Bob Cook in third. And, Haynes and Orris have an almighty crash on turn two. And Dykoff and Taylor are racing. Dykoff can't resist Gary Turbo Turner's back end. And Taylor can't resist Dave Barber. Dennis Whiteman does a lap. Dennis Whiteman does another lap. And what a fantastic team final now, with 97, Jamie Dykoff leading it for the Suicide Squad. Barry Wilshire gets one from Kevin Wood. Kevin King is getting completely mullered. Steve Taylor tries to get Kevin Wilshire off the Kev Waller car. Oh, I say, and look at Kevin King's Cortina. It's been totaled. It's been totaled. And Dykoff has been done by Orris. And Barber has been done. And Wilshire's back in the race. Wilshire is back in the race, and it's all happening now on the pit bend. And who's doing the laps now then, goodness gracious me? It's still Dykoff in car number 97. Ray Orris picks him up and flicks him out, and Taylor follows him round. And Wilshire goes in on Turner, and Orris on Whiteman, and Wilshire again, the other one this time, coming to join in. Need some help, brother? Here I come. Oh, I say, and he completely mullers Chris Carter. In comes Orris on Wilshire and jacks him up beautifully. Burrows gets jacked up by Kevin. No, is that Ray or Kevin? I can't tell. It's Neil Barber. And we are witnessing the best Bayer team final of all time here this afternoon. These guys have spent months building these cars. We're halfway there. And months building these cars. We're halfway there. And with four laps to go, it is absolutely fantastic.
Good orange squash. It's all about to be unravelled, revealed and demolished. That tyre waiting for somebody on that first turn looks like a place to go, and away they go. The squash going away to a nice start. Oops, they're all over the place, ladies and gentlemen. First blood for the squash, and then they get squashed against the fence. It's Darren Wolfe in number 9, charged across the speedway track. Stevie Davis in number 77 is in hot pursuit. Davis will hang him on the arm curve if he gets half an opportunity. It's going to be a hard race, but a fast race. The other one was pure demolition. This one looks like it's going to be fast. Terry Skeith gets put around by Treble 3. Whoops, number 7, your lead. 77, the leader, I thought so. 77, Steve Davis leads for the Condoms. Down the back stretch goes Steve. He used to race saloon stock cars. He's been in banger racing for a long time. Always has a great time out there on the track. Terry Skeith's car looking a little the worse for wear as it comes under attack from number 29, Dave Edwards. There's Davis in 77, Skeep in number 3, and 5-1-1 also in second position for the squash. That's Don Anderson. So Anderson, the pace man for the squash, can he catch Steve Davis? Well, 29 Edwards. Oh, he climbs all over the Edwards car, stops it into the turn. Well, yep, that certainly put Edwards around. All the chaos is happening down here. There's Vince Wolfe is in there, 240 Mel Reed is in there. They're all hooked together. And in the middle is Davis, 77, being taken for a ride across the infield. Whoops, their mud's flying, the silencers are dropping off. Steve Davis, I think, still in the lead at this time. There goes number 9, Wolf, looking for aggravation. 33 now in second position. And it looks like Davis is stuck in the... he's not, he's escaped, but Wolf's going to take him. He goes for the right front of the Davis car. That stops him. So we're looking for 33, also for the Condoms. He's in the pole. Absolute traffic jam. Steve Davis is going back in there looking for action. He's got the front right struck off the car now. 295 gets ahead on. 33 comes through to take up the lead. That's Tony Wade for the Condoms. Second position now, we haven't got a clue. There's nobody passing the line. They're all there on the pit turn, knocking 7 bells out of each other. So the man who has got to somehow get through all that traffic and all that has been, but a big steam goes Brian McGuinness. McGuinness could be the man to shift him, but here's the leader, 33. He gets through and McGuinness goes after him. He doesn't make it. He cannot handle the car now. Halfway, 4 laps next time for number 33. The man piling up the laps for the Condoms, Tony Wade. He seems to have gone unnoticed. There's hardly any orange squash still running. Terry Skeith's got a little bit of drive in car number 3. Number 14, Brian McGuinness, the man with it all to do. McGuinness, I think, from the Watford area, races for the Enfield team. Used to be a Bovindon banger man, I think, many years ago, but McGuinness is the only man with any power left to stop the leader. He takes a head on from number 29. And Skeef number... yeah, somewhat lucky there not to get involved, I think, 33. Tony Wade piling up the laps. He's got three to run. No, he's got two this time, I think. But three... It is, in fact... It is three laps. Tony Wade gets the three-lap one. Practicing safe sport. Oops, but it's not very safe because he's got Terry Skeef hanging about looking for trouble. He's also got his teammate, Mr. Finch, and 295, who is going down the track at an incredible rate of knots, considering Skeef is in trouble.
The championship final is about to destruct. And away we go, and in they go. It's heavy metal time. Steve Davis with the combo cam in the car, wipes himself all over Chris Carter, and then finds himself pointing the wrong way. Mega destruction on turn two, and fought the lead for the condom. Oh, and Wadey coming through there, takes out Wood, and Carter's been checked.
337, number 11, number 30. Then it's 19 and 33. And look at Ray Harris, number 13. And Steve Davis gets a head on. Let's hope the camera took that one. 79, Barbara has been jacked. A brand new car, totally destroyed. And on the home straight, the race leader is 337, Faulkner, running to the condom. Number 11, Bilkey, a surprise runner for the Mag 7. And Bilkey hits Faulkner on turn two, and here comes one of the two leaders. 33, Wadey is now doing that. And Bilkey and Faulkner are both gone, it would seem. Oh my word, and how did Wadey miss that head-on? Number 33, Wadey leading for the condom. 33, Wadey in the lead. As Stevens buries himself in Turner, Davis takes... Oh, what a hit on Wood! Going for Gary Turner. Gary Turner, always one of the best records for the Mag 7. Ray Owens has got it running again, and Wadey comes through it all. Number 33, way out in front now for the condom. 79, Barbara has been jacked, a brand new car, totally destroyed. And on the home straight, the race leader is 337, Faulkner running to the condom. Number 11, Bilkey, a surprise runner for the Mag 7. And Bilkey hits Faulkner on turn two, and here comes... Well, those are the two leaders. 33, Wadey is now doing that. And Bilkey and Faulkner are both gone, it would seem. Oh my word, and how did Wadey miss that head-on? Number 33, Wadey leading for the condom. 33, Wadey in the lead. As Stevens buries himself in Turner, Davis takes... Oh, what a hit on Wood! 33, Tony Wade the leader. 66, Dave Finch. Well, where's he going? He's going for Gary Turner. Gary Turner, always one of the best records for the Mag 7. Ray Owens has got it running again, and Wadey comes through it all. Number 33, way out in front now for the condom. Ray Harris jacks up Dave Finch. Carter hits Wadey. Now then, that was a good hit by Chris Carter there. And Bilkey hits Wadey. And then Ray Harris knows it. 33, Tony Wade, the leader. The former Banger World Champion. 66, Dave Finch looking for some action. 33, Wadey still leads. That's the one they've got to stop. Billy Brown still running in 4:55. And I must say that at the moment, the Pinkies look to be in control. Turner has a go at Wadey and misses. 19, Dave Edwards has a go at Turner and kicks. 33, Wadey leads. As Stinchy gives Bilkey a massive head-on. We're halfway there, Steve. Faulkner now lining up someone. If he can find a green one,
337, and the Condon car is running right now. The Mach 7 looks pretty unmagnificent. Right away, needs a bump start. Tony Pember is still running, and this is a comprehensive performance by the Grayson Condon. The Banger world title going to Kent this year with Chris Whiteman, and now the Banger team title going to Kent, it would seem, with the Grayson Condon. 250, Tony Pindler, the only man who can stop him. Edwards hits him, but Pindler still running. 3 laps to go now for 33, Tony Wade. Two next time. Oh, what a hit by Fitchy on some poor soul. And Pindler gets absolutely bullet down there, but still he's running. It's only Tony Pindler now, still left for the Mach 7. And Tony Pindler still running and still...